sincere gratitude to law enforcement for all the efforts that they've made, and you see all the agencies that have been here and been a part of this, working all through the night and all day. I know there's some questions about the number of victims that we have, and Aaliyah will be providing some information about that shortly, and about the number of victims that are involved in this. We are here to serve the victims. Our office has a website, www.5thCircuitDA.org. That's www.5thCircuitDA.org. There is a specific tab on there for victim services. It includes information about the Victims Compensation Fund and things of that nature. And the victims and the family of victims may contact our office directly also, but can also do that through this website. Because of the size of this, we are fortunate to have both victim service officers from the Federal Bureau of Investigations as well as the Office of Prosecutorial Services in Montgomery that are going to be assisting our victim service officers in serving these victims. Our thoughts and prayers are with all the families. There are no words to describe the emotions that we're all feeling. And with that being said, I'll turn the podium over to Aaliyah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Again, I'm Sergeant Jeremy Burkett with the Alabama Law Enforcement Agency, and I am going to provide an update relative to the situation that occurred here in Dadeville, Alabama, which is inside of Tallapoosa County. Okay, before I get into that, I'm going to reiterate exactly what Mike just said, what the district attorney just shared with everybody. Thank you so much for your support and your continued patience, as well as the community. There's been an overwhelming show of support from the community for us in law enforcement. And if it's not for what you're doing, for the information that's being provided right now, and the support that you're showing us, we would not be able to do our job. So we're extremely grateful and thankful for that. As it relates to the fatalities from the event from today, there are still four lives lost. Four lives were lost in the tragic event that occurred here in Dadeville. As far as the injuries, there are 28 individuals that were injured during the course of the incident. That's 28 individuals injured during the course of the incident. Now, some of those injuries are critical. They are in critical condition, and that's why it's so important. We absolutely need everyone to continue to pray for those individuals to allow them to recover from what they're enduring, as well as their families. That's why that's so important, okay? Now, please understand, when we classify an injury, it could be, as I said, something extremely critical or serious, or it could be something as simple as they needed medical treatment, okay? So that is a wide variety of injuries that were sustained, but please understand, this is also a very fluid situation. We have been getting continuous updates throughout the day, and we are absolutely trying to confirm and understand everyone that was in the venue there near the 200 block last night. We're going through that process right now. We're going through it in a very methodical way. We're not going to rush. We're not going to rush to failure. We're going to do exactly what we need to do to ensure justice is brought to bear for those families. And I also want to just share and reiterate, We've got to have information from the community. So if you are at home right now, or you know somebody that has any information about what occurred last night, I cannot stress this enough, ever how minor you think it is, we absolutely need you to share it. So again, please reach out to the Alabama Law Enforcement Agency, State Bureau of Investigation. That 1-800 number is 1-800-392-8011, 1-800-392-8011, or you can go online, submit it there, sbi.investigations@aaliyah.gov. That's sbi.investigations investigations@alia.gov. Also, Central Alabama Crime Stoppers has offered a reward for any of the information, so please contact them as well. That's Central Alabama Crime Stoppers. That number is 1-833-AL-1-STOP, S-T-O-P. That's 1-833-AL-1-STOP, STOP. Again, I'll make all of that information available in a press release to everyone as soon as this is over with. But I also want to just share one last thing before we get ready to conclude. How thankful I am to all of our local, state, and federal partners. We are extremely fortunate in the state of Alabama to have an amazing relationship, and not with just the law enforcement. There have been first responders, our paramedics, the firefighters. That this community has just truly showed overwhelming support. There's a vigil going on right now for the families and those that lost. This is a time, again, I'll agree with the district attorney, hey, there's just no words to express what some of the families are having to try to now understand and cope with. So we just ask that you continue to be patient with us. Please be patient with us as we go through this process. We're absolutely doing everything we can, and all available resources are being made available. I will not be taking any questions at this time. Again, if you have any questions about this situation, please email media.relations@alia.gov. media.relations@alia.gov. Thank you.
Can you not identify the dead?
Can you tell us of the suspects?
Is there anybody in custody?